Hey y'all, it's Nick from Undefeated Productions, and welcome back. In this one, we're going to be discussing the trade that has sent Robbie Ray from the Arizona Diamondbacks to the Toronto Blue Jays. Before we get started, hit that like button and subscribe. Again, I said this with the Mike Minor trade. I am almost done with the Mike Clevinger complete trade reaction. That one's taking me a little while to edit. There's nine players, nine different players I need to have highlights for, nine different players to talk about. It's a longer one, so make sure to hit the subscribe button, hit the bell so you're notified when that uploads. Again, that's coming up shortly right after this. I'm almost done with it. Alrighty, basically, a big trade here for the Toronto Blue Jays. Robbie Ray. Robbie Ray this season is pitching to a 7.84 ERA in 31 innings, 43 strikeouts, and a 2 whip. Career-wise, Robbie Ray is a 4.25 ERA pitcher in 821 and two-thirds innings pitched. He has 1,017 strikeouts and a 1.375 whip. Robbie Ray was an all-star in 2017 when he pitched 162 innings of 2.89 ERA baseball. He struck out 218 and walked 71. So control has always been a big issue for Robbie Ray in his career. And as you see this year, he's also had struggles keeping going deeper into games and not allowing many runs, as he has a 7.84 ERA. Robbie Ray has a massive ERA this year, but the Blue Jays here are getting this rental piece in Robbie Ray, hoping that he can perform anything to what he did back in 2017, where he pitched to that 2.84 ERA. And if they get anything close to a mid-3 ERA from Robbie Ray, this trade is well worth it. Again, as Taijuan Walker, you're going to take a semi-chance on him and hope that he performs out good. Now, what they're giving up is Travis Bergen. Bergen this year in one and two-thirds innings pitch is three strikeouts, a 1.200 whip, and has a 0 ERA. Career-wise, Bergen has a 5.06 ERA in 22 games, 21 and a third innings pitched, 21 strikeouts, and a 1.359 whip. So Bergen, a left-hand pitching prospect, will be heading over to the Diamondbacks. The Diamondbacks are making basically getting rid of the rest of Ray's contract. Again, you're not going to tender qualifying offer to him, so you're going to get something for him now. No one would have taken that. He probably would have accepted TQA. So overall, I think this is a great trade for the Diamondbacks, great trade for the Blue Jays. I think both sides win this here. Let me know what y'all think in the comment section below. Hit that like button and subscribe. More videos coming up on the trades as they start to heat up again, and I'll see y'all next one. Thanks for watching.